Hello, hello, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to finally start my Shop My Stash series. I have been wanting to do a series like this for a very long time, and that is because I have a lot of new makeup I have been buying in hauls and I've never tried them. Or I haven't tried them enough to really form an opinion about them. So I have a project pan, so I have a lot of stuff in my project pan, but I also want to just pick a few items. I'm not going to do a full face, I'm just going to pull some items out of my collection and see if I like them at the end of the month or not, and what my thoughts are about them, so I get a little bit more use out of the products I already own. This time I can't really take you around into my collection. I will in the future, but at the moment I am redecorating my beauty room. That is going to be a video all of in itself, but right now everything is still in boxes, or a part of it, it's, you know, in like drawers that shouldn't be in there. So once I get it all organized, I'm just going to take you along through the drawers, but right now I just have this box or this basket of some stuff I really want to try out, and I am going to take you along for the ride. Okay, as I was saying, I just pulled a few products. It's not a full face by any means, but I just wanted to just get to know some stuff, and I've really kept in mind that I'm also doing a project pen and I don't want to get too much in the way of that. So yeah, I'm going to just pull some stuff out of here. I'm going to show you. I'm going to start off with some primer I am going to use a little bit more this month, and I pulled this e.l.f. poreless body primer. The reason why I pulled this is because I have been trying the Smashbox pore minimizing primer and I really enjoy it, so I really want to try this one a little bit more as well to see what I think of this primer. Then for foundation, I have pulled this Fenty Beauty one. I am in the shade 185. It's called the Pro Filter, and it says it is a hydrating and long wear foundation. I bought this a few months ago when I was in London with some friends. I bought it in the Boots store, and I think I only used it once or twice since I've bought it. And a lot of people are so raving about this one. It's like holy grail status, or it's like very high up in their ranking video, so I really want to get to know this. And I think it's a good shade for me right now in winter, and I think I can carry it over to spring as well. So it's like I want to get some use out of it, and I want to get to know it a little bit better. So yeah, this is what I pulled for foundation. For bronzer, I am going to get this bronzer from ColourPop. I don't really know what shade it is. I'm going to look it up, and I hope I will put it up here, or it's going to be down in the description box. But I got this. This is a single pan, and I think it's a very nice shade. It's not too warm. It looks quite cool toned and not too dark for me, because I have quite a heavy hand, so I don't really want a very dark bronzer to begin with, because I am going to be blending till the cows come home. So yeah, this I really want to try out. I think it looks really nice. I think by looking at the pen, I think I've used it once or twice, so I want to get to know it a little bit more. So this is my bronzer for this month. Then for highlighter, I pulled this Fenty Beauty. This one, it's in the shade Lightning Dust and Fire Crystal. It's in the kilowatt range. What I really like about this highlighter, and I am trying to see what I prefer, is that you have a slightly like less obvious one, more glowy, and the other one has a lot more sparkle in it. So I'm really curious to see what I prefer, if I'm going to use the sparkly side as well, or if it's just going to make me look ashy. So yeah, I have been using, as you can see, some of the texture on this side. I have been using this one a lot more than I have been using this one, so I just want to get to know it a little bit better and see, yeah, if I want to buy more in the range. Then I have some eye stuff. I have another complexion thing. It's still in its package. It's the Makeup Forever Ultra HD Self-Capturing and Self-Setting Concealer. And I got it in the shade 31. I'm going to get it out of its box. This is something I haven't used at all. I bought it in Madrid. It's a very light shade, but I think I should be all right. I think this is a nice color for me. And I'm really curious about this concealer because I hear people saying they love it. I hear people saying they don't. I just want to make up my own mind. And this is for me a year where I really want to find some Holy Grail concealers. And some Holy Grail eyeshadow primer. So that's a whole thing of itself. But yeah, I am really curious to try this. There's 5 mils in here. So I'm really curious about the self-setting part. And I want to know if it's not going to be too drying because of that on my under eye. And also it says light capturing. I have quite deep, not bags, but you know, I have some dark circles, let's call it that. And I hope that the light capturing property of this is going to make it look more bright under my eyes. So yeah, that's my concealer. Then for my mascara, I am going to use this Climax mascara by NARS. I have been using this a bit, but I'm not really that intrigued by it. Or not really that... I have no clue what this is. I'm not really too sure about this yet. Even though on paper this should be something I like, because it's the formula is not too wet, it's not too dry either, but it's not too wet. I really like the wand shape, it's not too big, it's in this hourglass shape, I really enjoy. So this is, should be something I kind of like, but I don't know if I really do. So I want to use it a little bit more and really get to know it and see if this is something that could be a nice companion to my Holy Grail Monsieur Big from Lancôme. So yeah, we will see. And then I have two eyeshadow palettes I'm going to show you after these. I have two eyebrow products. I've pulled this brow gel gel. It's a clear gel. Can you focus on the thing? It's the Brow Gel by Tanya Crooks, and it's just a clear gel that is water resistant. It's like this very big spoolie wand. I must say, I kind of enjoy it because lately I have had some brow mascaras that are dispersing a lot of pigment, a lot of product, and I'm done with my brows. I just want to set them and they... I don't know, it mucks it all up again. So yeah, this is something I am really intrigued by. I want to see if this is going to hold my brows in place. I don't really have extremely unruly brows, but I have a lot of hairs in my brows. I'm quite lucky in that regard. And yeah, I'm looking for something that is going to keep them nice and tidy and in their place, but is not going to muck up what I've already put down with a pencil. Because the pencil I pulled, I'm also going to try this pencil by It Cosmetics. It's the Brow Power. And this is one I got in London as well, together with the foundation. And this is something the girl in the store, I think I bought it at Selfridges. She said that this is like a universal brow color. Well, we all know there's no such thing, but I really want to take this for a spin and see if it's at least something that will fit my brows. In the store it really did, so yeah, I want to get more use out of it, see if I like it. It has quite a big tip, I hope you can see. I'm going to just show you like this. It's not as big as the Brauvo one, but it's a little like oval shaped. So that's nice. I don't really think it's precise enough to really draw like those hair-like strokes. But yeah, I don't really need that, to be honest. I just have to fill them in a bit. I want to try this out. I want to see if I like it. I want to see if it's too pigmented, not pigmented enough. If the color suits me, I have it on today. I kind of like it. So yeah, we're going to see at the end of the month if I like it or not. And then the last thing, and I already said it wasn't a lot I was going to try this month, but the last thing I pulled were 2 eyeshadow palettes. I'm going to try the Viseart Petit Pro in 3, and I want to play a little bit more with the Going Coconuts. I am going to show them to you so you know what I'm talking about. That is this one. This is the Going Coconuts one. It's a very neutral, nice eyeshadow palette. I have been playing with it a lot. I took it to England this last week and I've really enjoyed playing with it. I just want to get to know it a little bit better because I didn't really use all the shades yet. And yeah, so I have this one, and I also have the Petit Pro from Viseart, as I showed you, and this has a little bit more color. And I think it's nice to have this little one in the last like month of winter and going into spring, because what I really like, you have like two sections in this one. You have this that could make like a nice look, but you also can use these to make a look. I have bought this, I think, around Christmas, and I haven't used it before now or before last week, so it's been laying in my eyeshadow drawer for like 2 months or something. And I think I should get to know this a little bit better. So guys, that is practically everything I pulled out of my stash to have a little shop my stash moment. I am going to try and keep put these videos up on the second week of the month. I'm going to try to keep that like rhythm routine in there, because I have a lot of series on my channel and I have to fit them in somewhere, and I just want you to know that in the first week I do this, in the second week I do that, in the third week, and so on. So I think this is going to be a second week of the month type of moment when I am putting these videos up. I'm going to use these next to my Project Pen stuff for a full month, and then at the end of the month I'm going to let you know what I think about the products, and then I'm going to pull some new ones. So yeah, and I'm going to try not to make them too long, because I don't want to have only 30 minutes videos on my channel. So yeah, that's it for now. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. Let me know down below what type of product you're most curious about. If you want to see me do some looks with the eyeshadow palettes I'm using, please let me know down below so I can arrange that. And subscribe if you haven't already. And I hope I will see you in my next one. Bye!